Hello, my name is Fern G. Carr. My website is www.ferngzcarr.com. Welcome to my series, Shards of Crystal Book Launch, Part 4. I'm pleased to share excerpts from the launch of my poetry collection, Shards of Crystal. The launch took place in New Westminster, a member municipality of Metro Vancouver, BC, Canada. It's also the location of Silver Bow Publishing. The event was organized by my publisher, Poet Laureate Emerita Candace James, and was hosted by Warren Dean Fulton, the MC of Poetry New Westminster's Poetic Justice Reading Series. This is part 4 of 5 of my book launch. Enjoy!
Okay, a funeral in the rain. Under a slate-colored sky, raindrops pelt umbrellas balanced on long legs flamingo-like above weary heads. Silent tears blend with the rain and trickle onto the drenched grass. All is quiet except for the drone of a prayer for the deceased and the occasional whoosh of a distant car splashing through puddles, oblivious to the grief of those who mourn. As the service concludes, some linger in the rain-soaked cemetery to pay their respect to loved ones who've long since passed on to their final resting place. A place where it doesn't matter why the bereaved weep, for the deceased or for themselves, a grim reminder of their own mortality. They shed tears that subside like the rain as the clouds pass and those above ground depart to resume their daily routines. I was actually going to say that when I originally wrote this, I wrote it as a visual poem, and it was in the shape of a headstone and a plot, but I just found that it was a little bit tricky to read, so I wrote it in regular stanza form after that. Now we move on to something semi-spooky, and it's called Dare Not Disturb the Periwinkle. Periwinkles are beautiful flowers. I actually have some in my garden. They're a nice purplish blue color. And I was quite surprised to find that there is some folklore behind them. So I embellished it a little bit in my epigram and I said, "'Tis bad fortune to remove the periwinkle from a graveyard, for ye shall vex the spirits dwelling within." Anyway, Darren. Okay, dare not disturb the periwinkle. Dare not disturb the periwinkle, the myrtle that creeps across barren sod, twixt granite headstones, above the caskets of the corpses below. Dare not disturb the periwinkle, a sacrilege worthy of the wrath of the shades who haunt these hallowed grounds. Dare not disturb their shrouds woven from the graveyard vine, whose flowers are as blue as the lips of the dead. Dare not disturb the periwinkle. And then another semi-supernatural type poem. I wrote it in bilingual, I wrote it in Spanish actually. It was called Noche Tras Noche, and then I translated it into English and I wrote it, you know, as side by side format like that. But I won't read the Spanish, I'll just read the English part. Okay, night after night. Night after night, in the silence of my bed, when the walls reflect the shadows of trees dancing sensuously in the moonlight, I think of the souls who whisper their secrets, trying to explain their spectral existence, frustrated, the dead without words. Okay, now the book at this point starts moving towards the light, if I can use that cliche. And it's called A Metamorphosis of Darkness to Light. And what I did was I made a point of each poem having imagery that got progressively more and more, that got brighter. And this first poem, Cruel Jazz, Warren mentioned the Bushcart Prize. I was absolutely bowled over it at that nomination. I was so thrilled. And that poem was very meaningful to me too, Cruel Jazz, because I happened to be a musician and pianist at one time. And so I wrote this poem, and I wrote it so that it was on a music staff, so that it would mimic sheet music, piano music. So I'll start off with that, Cool Jazz. A curl of thin blue smoke snakes around a half-empty glass of scotch, stale scotch. And as the ice cubes melt, the lazy swishing of a brush caresses percussion cymbals. The mellow clucking of thick strings on the double bass is in counterpoint with the twang of an electric guitar and the pained expression on a guitarist's face. While sultry saxophone, this is in smaller font, that's why I'm having trouble here. While sultry saxophone romances the house, confident fingers fly across the keyboard. Pianist, eyes closed, sways back and forth, entranced by the rhythm he creates. Shoulders heaving as he makes love to the piano. It's jazz, and it's cool, baby. Uh-huh.
Acknowledgements. All poems contained herein and Shards of Crystal photo copyright Fern G. Z. Carr. A Funeral in the Rain, Dare Not Disturb the Periwinkle, Noche Tras Noche, Night After Night, and Cool Jazz are from my poetry book, Shards of Crystal. A Funeral in the Rain, visual version, was first published in White Wall Review. Noche Tras Noche, Night After Night, Spanish version, was first published in Editorial Cielo Gris Poesía y Opinión. Cool Jazz was first published in the Worcester Review. Thanks very much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like or share, and please be sure to click subscribe. Thanks again.